Part of the argument is that the rent control provincial board does not have access, you know, to the tools that they need to properly assess, you know, whether or not this hardship application is valid. And part of what I hope to work on with you and with the support of my colleagues is to make sure that this board has access to the kind of expertise that they need in order to better evaluate these applications. I think they've been asking for this for a long time. And this is something that's true for every boarding commission that we have on the city side. You know, there's alcohol beverage control. A lot of times they're mandated to do certain things, but they don't have the kind of support or resources that they need to better protect the interests of our residents.
Absolutely. And to make sure that a landlord can't even put an application in when he knows that substantial rehabilitation, so don't even insult the board by applying if you know you have not made substantial rehabilitation in your building. And we have to make sure that we push it out from just the apartments, but the common area.
Matt, I ask you, sir, I ask you to stay for a moment, as well as this is a follow-up.
That's not Matt Shapiro.
I am sorry, Richard. I not only do I know his first name, I know his forgive me. I see, well, there are some of you in this room. Most of you in this room are disappointed at the verdict vote that was taken, but I see it as a new opportunity for us to now start from square one and develop something. I'm sorry that you don't agree with me. That's okay. And develop a piece of legislation that will last in perpetuity, not something that we're doing in the heat of the emotion, but with sound, deliberate conversation. For those of you who are currently living in rental housing, so Mr. Chairman, Mr. James, as a result of this morning's meeting, one of the best suggestions that was made was we need to find a way to meet with the landlords. The problem, Mr. Ball, is that every landlord is not going to show up. And more than likely, and someone said this in the meeting yesterday, they're going to send their attorney. So, we ask that those of you who have a decent relationship with your landlord, please encourage them as we go out in the county. Thank you. Yes,
Councilman Gonzalez. Yes, I heard someone saying that the people that met with the landlords and the administration were not their representatives. So, if we meet with a group, there's always landlords that are going to be not represented because we don't have everyone. They say some people claim to be the president of this organization, the president of that organization. I represent every tenant in the city of Newark. It seems that that's not the case because now Victor was yelling that person didn't represent us. So we need to have people that claim to represent all the tenants of the city of Newark, and that's not going to be possible because most tenants don't want to be represented by the individuals that claim to be the representative.
Thank you. Our next item is support. And thank you all for coming and voicing your opinion. We do value.
Mr. President, I would like to ask the Mayor to authorize the Mayor of Panama, his designated Deputy Mayor, to enter into an agreement to exchange land and build a new development facility, but even exchange certain city-owned properties located in the south ward. Mr. President, I wish to be heard on this order.